It's Frosty, Heidi, and Frank on 95.5 KLOS.
I saw this, Christian, that it takes two parts of your brain to break down a song. One tackles the music, the other handles the lyrics, and it's either side, like the left handles the lyrics and the right handles the melodies.
Yes.
So Christian's brain is totally interconnected.
I'm a genius.
He's absolutely genius.
Or an idiot savant. It's a fine line.
He's basically wiring our brains to work both sides at once.
You're welcome. Maybe I should get paid more.
You should.
You know
hey, whoever's
saying?
Listening, pay
double
him
it.
More.
Double it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I would like to briefly comment that I was in the other room watching the television and...
Oh, they have a TV in there?
Yeah, they have a big screen TV.
Nice.
Eric is adorable.
Isn't he, though?
I mean, it really is quite something. You know, it's almost like there's an 11-year-old that learned how to grow a mustache.
I know.
But it's part of the Make-A-Wish Foundation that he wanted to produce a Market 2 radio station morning show. You just look at him, you see, he's amazing.
Yeah.
It's gorgeous.
It really is.
Anyway,
what
all right.
Cutie.
So I thought. I dropped the ball because last month was Black History Month, and it would have been a great thematic rounding off to have done a band where the band was made up of African Americans.
Sure.
So dropped the ball. So I'm going to do it in March retroactively because I thought that this is actually probably one of the most requested songs that I have. Living Color. Ridiculous. Cult of Personality from 1988's Vivid, featuring four of the sickest musicians. I mean, these guys, it's no joke. You got Will Calhoun on drums, who won the Buddy Rich Jazz Masters Award from Berkeley, which we all know that most people from Berkeley are unbearable when it comes to being musicians. They'll be this like CrossFit. They'll tell you that they went to Berkeley very quickly into the conversation.
Can I name drop?
Yeah, please.
Buddy Rich. I met him when I was a teenager. One of the greatest drummers
of all time. Yep.
Mainly in like the 40s, or big band era, Buddy Rich.
Yeah. He's amazing. There's actually a great tape of him yelling at his band because he was also a madman. And he gets on the bus and he's yelling at them for sucking that night. And then he stops and he's, and I forget the dude's name, but he's basically like, Babylon, you guys, what is that? Mike, what is that? And you hear him go, it's a mustache. And he's like, how many times have I told you nobody in my band has a mustache? And that's why in the Beastie Boys song it says I fly off the handle like Buddy Rich. It's because of that tape. Anyway, Buddy Rich is amazing, as is Will Calhoun. This drum beat, sick. Turn it up. I mean, smashy bashy, rock and roll. There's a couple of fills that are just... little turnaround of the beat. Produced by Mick Jagger and Ed Stasium. Ed Stasium took more of the work on this one because Mick Jagger actually produced Living Color's demo that got them signed and was the one who went into all the record labels and was like, sign these guys because they got turned down by everybody else. So Mick Jagger, thank you.
Wow.
Yep. Just ride some work. Come on, this one. Oh, man. So musical. I just love the idea of like a jazz drummer. It's like, you know, it's the same thing as Neil Peart and all these other guys. Like, play everything that you can and then do your rock and roll. This fill.
Wow.
Beautiful. It's beautiful. It's exactly what the song required. Like, if you go to that bit, it's doing this. Brilliant. Brilliant work. And then, of course, you need your mandatory shaker and tambourine because nothing says social inequity like tambo and shaker. If you're going to raise your fist, then you should do it with a shaker in your hand. I'm like, oh, let me just provide a slight little backbeat. Sick. Oh, yeah. That's it. That's how you raise a rabble. You do it with a well-played tambourine. On bass, Muzz Skillins, one of the greatest bass names of all time, replaced by equally great named Doug Wimbish. But this... This is the dude playing it. So listen to the turnaround here, there, Frosty. You hear this? It goes into the time signal change. Right here.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's much smarter than you think. So he does this for the verse, which is sick. And then we come up on this on the pre-chorus.
Are those loose strings? Did you get that sound?
That's what she said. What they are is they're not loose, but the way he's playing is playing with his fingers, not with a pick, so it's a little flobblier and sort of movinger. I think it might be a different tuning. I can't really tell. But he's flying all over the neck on this thing. And then on the ending, they do the turnaround. It's so good because they do it twice to get the... And then, so here's the ending bit when we do this. I'll just play it to you so you can hear in context. It does this. So it sounds like this. Ready?
It sounds like I don't know how to say it.
Please, say it. As we said, there's no such thing as stupid questions or stupid comments, just people that make them.
It's awesome, but it kind of sounds like he doesn't, like it's wrong.
Yeah, no, it's so wrong, it's right.
It's like, what are you doing there? It's like, I'm just fooling around to see where I want to go.
Because the nice thing is that when you put it in the mixer, you don't hear all the floppiness. You just hear... Because when we get the guitars...
So the bass and the guitar doing the exact same note.
Yeah, yeah. When we come to the guitar track, I'll play them together, and it's awesome. So the band is also made up of Vernon Reed on guitar, who is a ridiculous guitar player. But this riff...
We know what it is.
We know what it is immediately. And I was reading an article where they were talking to Tom Morello of Rage Against the Machine, and he said the first time that he heard Cult of Personality was the first time that he thought that he'd be able to have a band. And if you think about it, this is, except for the lyric, the vocals from Corey Glover, the rest of this could easily be a Rage Against the Machine song. Sick guitar riff. God, it's so good. When you put it in together with the bass, man, these dudes. Nobody. And then you put the drums in, and finally it's... That bass drum hits. Do you hear it? It's that stagger.
Yeah.
Sick. What is it doing time signatures-wise there? Is it adding an extra one? It's three.
Measure 3/4?
Yeah, so it goes
three measures one, of 4/4.
Yeah, exactly. You get the turnaround.
It's like being in a foreign country. No idea what anybody's talking about.
They almost turn into a waltz for one day.
I'm just going to smile and go,
yeah. It sounds like it's,
your brain doesn't work together like everybody else.
No, my brain is very unique. I'm a one of a kind.
I think if you say it with that accent, it sounds really smart. Your brain doesn't work.
Your brain don't work like
my
that.
My brain broke. I don't get it.
Hurts. I'm going to do the math right quick for you there, lady. Yeah. It's 1/3, 4/4, and then it comes in off of the... but it's just this riff is so brilliant, and you can't unhear it. And then on the other track, he does this in the verse where he goes. Little jazzy chords, because they're all. So good. So just this wang, just to give it that little extra beat. The cult of personality. I know you're angry. Brilliant. And then the chorus, we get this business.
Sounds like a motorcycle.
Right?
Yeah. Up.
It's so good.
Did somebody put a bar on his finger, like a slide?
Like, I don't know if it's a slide or if he actually somehow can do it with his finger on the fretboard. Because I can't imagine that you played the whole thing, or he played the whole thing with like a finger. You know, like whether it just sounds like a slide on it. But he may have done. But it's really fluid. And then the first lead. And now that once I read that article, I was like, there's so much Tom Morello in this thing. I mean, this is the first lead, so it happens in the. Brilliant, man. And then the other thing you don't notice is that the riff actually goes on the second one. Amazing. With the bass. So simple. But it's like the AC/DC thing where it's like, keep it simple, stupid. Or the Kiss thing. So I'm going to get to this again. The chorus. Whatever this weird guitar tone is, it's clearly one on either side. Unless you're, you know, obviously challenged like Heidi and can't have your brain separate.
Right, I only hear it in my one side.
All right. With the bass. Oof. Hendrix.
That.
It's amazing. Like, I'm telling you right now, man. It's what Wimbush is. I mean, what Muzz Skillens is doing here. Huh. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's so well executed, man. I mean, it's not showing off. It's just like so. When you put it with the guitar and the drums. To the riff. And so then we have. So now you got the big lead. This is when he pulls out all the stops and is like, let me show everybody what I can do here on the old loaded six string on his back. So here we go with the. This is the main lead. We're like a third of the way through at this point, but I'm just gonna...
My God.
Yeah, we're halfway through. We're halfway through, everybody. Amazing.
It's like data transmission.
It's just ridiculous. Yeah, it's like when your modem when you first plugged it in back in the 80s. Like, This sick. I mean, it's got everybody in there. There's Van Halen. There's like the early blues when he goes to this. It's like ZZ Top. It's amazing. Like this guitar solo has like all of the, you know, it's like what they say in jazz, right? Like in order to become a great jazz musician, you have to learn how to play like everybody else before you can play with yourself.
Yeah.
So this guitar solo is like a time machine that shows you all of the moves of guitar from the
like
blues,
the evolution of it,
exactly,
all.
Like all the way through, and then creates this new sound, and then it's clear that this is a major influence on Tom Morello, because this is all like this bit. This is your Van Halen's, your Yngwie's, all of the rock stars of the time. There's a little Stevie Ray Vaughan in there. Then it starts to become chaotic a little bit. Now you start to see Tom Morello show up. Hendrix. So it's so brilliant, man. If you can't. And then we go straight blues. Just for a moment. And then out. And then you're done.
Oh, my God.
Amazing work, man.
You think that was one take? Because this is pre-digital days where you now you can punch stuff in, but it's seamless.
It's seamless. Wow. And there doesn't seem to be a moment when you could have conveniently cut in, and you would probably hear it because of the way that he's using his sustain. You would have heard a truncation, as we like to call it in the business. So on vocals, Corey Glover, try to do this yourselves.
Look in my eyes, what do you see?
Perfect control right off the bat. That eyes is right on.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? The cult of personality. I know your anger, I know your dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality.
So much R&B.
Like Mussolini and Kennedy. I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality. Neon lights, Nobel Prize. When a mirror speaks, the reflection lies.
I don't know who Amir is, but whoever it was, he was a liar.
Why are you lying, Amir?
Yeah, it's not cool.
He won't have to follow me. Only you can set me free.
Man.
I sell all the things you need to be.
But he's not yelling. You hear how this is a completely controlled?
I sell all the things you need to be.
Like this Prince in there.
I'm the smiling face on your TV. Oh, I'm the...
I've never known the words before.
Oh, right.
This is really, I'm like.
You see, your brain, you can't separate.
The problem is that what you suffered from there.
Your lyric brain's turned off.
My lyric brain, when the music's
your
playing.
Your music brain is lyric, working.
Oh, and the music's off.
Oh, I'm the cult of personality. I exploit you. Still you love me. I tell you one and one makes three. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. Like Joseph Stalin and Gandhi. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
And then we get back to like, what is the chorus? Because the cult of personality bit is actually sort of the pre-chorus. And then you get to this bit, which
Neon
is the chorus, but isn't.
Nobel Prize. When a leader speaks, that leader dies. You won't have to follow me. Only you can set you free.
And then he falls. It's good stuff. Because what you do is like you
wake up.
You would do that either in a reverb, but he just falls off the microphone,
you free.
Which is why you can hear his voice get weaker as it goes on.
You gave me fortune.
And then this last bit.
You gave me fame.
His notes.
You gave me power in your God's name.
Get out.
I'm every person you need to be. Oh.
Here we go.
I'm the cult of personality.
So good.
I'm the cult of
I'm in the bathtub. Right here. I'm in the bathtub.
It's not in the bathtub. Oh, it's that's a significantly
all these years.
Less.
Yeah, all these years.
Yeah, wasn't in the bathtub.
You have ruined this song. Now. I always hear what you just did.
You'll
never listen to music the same way again. How do you ruin the music every Monday at 9 o'clock?
That's the segment.
So there's these amazing harmonies.
Personality.
Which together goes.
The cult of personality.
So R&B.
I'm the cult of personality. The cult of personality. The cult of personality.
It's just brilliant, man. You like this is an R&B vocal over the top of what would become Rage Against the Machine.
I'm in the bathtub. Personality.
Yeah, it's not that. All right, so let's check your history. All right, so there's three samples in this song. The first one is this
and
one.
During the few moments that we have left, we want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.
Who's that? Look at all the white people.
Yeah, it's an astronaut. That's Neil Armstrong.
No.
It's Malcolm X.
Oh, okay. That's what I was going to say.
And then the next one is this one.
Ask not what your country can do for you.
Which is, of course,
Bernie Sanders.
John Fitzgerald Kennedy.
Kennedy, yes. And then the last one is.
The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Captain Kangaroo.
That's the other one, yes. It's FDR. So this is a room full of people who knew all the white person's quotes and not the black person's quotes. So that just goes to...
But I thought it was I'm in the bathtub, so don't look by me. I'm not a representation
you're useless.
Of the show.
That is Cult of Personality, Living Color. The record is called Vivid. It also has Glamour Boys on it, which is crazy. Also check out King's X. Also check out Rage Against the Machine. And I'm going to send this one out to my man, John, who's just been notified that he is now terminal with his illness. That is horrible news, but his spirit is unbelievable. Keep going, John, man. Enjoy every sandwich. All right, do a shot for John. I'll do a shot for John as well. So I've canceled my trip to New York only because I don't want to get the coronavirus. That's not happening. I'm going to move it to April and work out. The dust has settled. I am at the Segerstrom Center this Friday night. I can't believe it's happening so quickly. For Beatles night, 2 hours of the Beatles. It's going to be insane. Just come on down. Tickets are available from their website. And then, of course, the Carly Rae Jepsen show at the end of the month with the Cars. And that one is going to be one of my favorites. I'm telling you that right now. Tickets available at thesessiononair.com. King Trut on Instagram and Christian James Han on Facebook. To John.
Fantastic.
Salute. John. I'm in the bathtub.
Oh, yeah. I'm in the bathtub.
Yeah.
Jeez. All right. Keep it here.
Coffee chaser.
It doesn't get any better.
It will at 10 o'clock. We're fast out of here.